Let's begin by creating a new project. We can create a new project from File, New Project. This will bring up the New Project wizard. The first thing we need to do is set the destination or path to our new project. I'm going to put this new project on my desktop. I'm going to call the new project Rollerball. And then I will click on Create Project to make a new project. We now have our new project with a new empty scene. Before creating anything in the new scene, we need to save our scene. We can save our scene by going to File, Save Scene, or by using the keyboard shortcut. I'm going to save this scene in the Assets directory in a new folder called underscore scenes. The underscore is optional. I use it to sort this folder to the top of my project window. Now I'm going to call the scene Minigame. We can now see in our Scenes folder the scene called Minigame. Let's create our game board or playfield. To do this, we will use a stock Unity plane. We can create this plane from either Game Object, Create Other, Plane, or from inside the Hierarchy view using the Create menu. Rename this game object Ground. We can do this by either selecting the game object and using the Enter or Return key to allow editing, or by clicking on the game object twice, slowly. Type in the new name and hit Enter or Return to confirm this change. Reset the Transform component using the context-sensitive gear menu in the upper right. This will place the game object at the location of 000 in our scene. This point is known as the origin point of the world, and this is where all of the coordinates in the scene are calculated from. Now, with the game object selected and the cursor over the scene view, type the F key or choose Frame Selected from the Edit menu to see the entire game object in the scene view. We need to change the scale of the ground plane. We can do this in a number of ways. We can use the Scale tool. Simply grab the axis handle you want to change and drag the handle, rescaling the plane. We can click and drag on the title of the fields we want to change, or we can type a number directly into the field we want to change. You can tab between fields and hit Enter or Return to confirm your choice. Now remember, a plane has no volume, and scale does not work on the y-axis. There will be no change unless you go into negative numbers. In this case, the plane, which is a single-sided object, will simply face the other direction. If you place a plane in the scene and you can't see it, check your orientation between the plane and the camera, and make sure that you have the correct value for the y-axis of scale. This is usually the value of 1. Let's create our player object. In this assignment, our player object will be a Unity sphere. From the Hierarchy Create menu, select Sphere. Rename the sphere Player. Reset the transform to make sure it's at origin. Select Edit, Frame Selected, or use the F key while the cursor is over the scene view to focus our scene view camera on our game object. See how the sphere is buried in the plane? This is because both game objects are in the exact same location in the scene, the origin point, or 000 on the X, Y, and Z axes. We need to move the player's sphere up until it rests on the plane. All Unity primitive objects, cubes, spheres, capsules, have a standard size. They are either 1x1x1 or 1x2x1 Unity units. As such, we simply lift the player object up by half a unit in the Y axis, and we know it is lying perfectly on top of the plane. If we look in the game view, we can see it's very dark. There are no lights in the scene. Add a new directional light from the Hierarchy Create menu. Rename this Main Light. Reset the game object's transform to origin. Set the x-axis in the transform's rotation to 30, so it shines down on the game board. Now this light does not give good shape to the player's sphere, so set the transform's y-axis to 60 so the light comes in from one side. This gives a better shape to the ball. The player's position over the plane is somewhat ambiguous. It's hard to tell the player's exact position over the plane. Shadows will help with this. Set the shadow type on the main light to soft shadows, and set the resolution to very high resolution. Now it's hard to see the separation between the ball and its shadow. To help with this, let's add what is called a fill light. Duplicate the main light. Rename main light to fill light. Reverse the transform rotation values to minus 30 and minus 60, so the light shines up from below, but still from the front. Change the color value for the light to give a hint of blue. And lower the intensity to 0.1. Finally, turn off shadows. This will now act as a gentle fill light on the ball, separating it from its shadow. Let's look at the organization of our hierarchy. Even with only 5 game objects, the hierarchy is already getting confusing and is disorganized. Organization in our projects and our hierarchy are very important. We need to understand that organization at a glance. We organize our projects using folders or directories created by our operating system. We add these to our project using the Project View's Create menu. We organize our hierarchies by using game objects. In our scene, game objects can hold other game objects. Don't be afraid to use an empty game object as a directory or folder in the hierarchy. To do this, first create a new empty game object. Rename it Lighting. Reset the transform to origin, and this step is important. We want the transforms of all of our container game objects to be at origin before we use them. Add the fill light and the main light to the lighting parent game object. Now, see how these lights are in the middle of the game board? They are somewhat in the way. Remember, directional lights light all of the game objects in the scene based on their rotation, not their position. We can simply move their parent game object up 100 units above the game board. There they are, out of the way. Next, we'll find a way to move the player game object using player input.